So I'm going to explain the grana part here. There's a couple of things that I want to do different to the way it's shown in the picture. These were the initial pieces for the grana, okay? And I don't think there is adequate fabric in this to make it as wide as what I would like. I just want a little bit more flare than that. So these were pieces that were left from the sleeves, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this, and I'm going to lay this in such a way that this portion comes on the back leg over here, so that at the back of the camise you've got this pattern going up. And the other thing, so that would give it a little bit more width, so we've got another maybe 5 inches more on the width. And it will also add a little bit more definition to it. So I'm going to add this piece over here, and then most of this will get chopped away. Then on top of that, this was the piece that was left from the back of the camise. And I'm going to be adding this on top, whereas they've used like just the plain over here. I'm going to have that print, and where that print is going to show is, you know, where the jacks open up. I'm going to make sure that, you know, when the side view of the camise is apparent, you can just see that pattern going up on the sides of the jack rather than seeing the plain. And then it's obviously going to have this little bit of embroidery on the sides of it. Now if I did have lace, what I would like to have done was add that lace over here. And the lace that I have left, I've done like a fast video on that. The laces I've trimmed off, and I'm just going to show you what I will be doing with that. These are the laces. I'm going to be using this on the front diamond, the back diamond, and the sleeves. And then I've got one of these pieces that are going to be left over. I had two choices. I could have used it on top of over here, the thigh area, but it was just coming out maybe just a touch smaller. So I would like to use this because there is two portions of this. I've made this into the original fabric that came, which was in the raw silk. I'm going to make a trouser with that, and I'm going to add this to the bottom of the trouser. So we're going to have a grana and also a trouser. A grana is something that you would wear to a very special function. A trouser you could wear to most occasions. So I'm going to have like a 2-in-1 with this, and you can get that out of the same fabric. The only thing that I would advise is to get maybe 4.5 yards of lining fabric, which is not going to cost you that much, about 5-6 pounds in total. So buy the extra lining and then be versatile, because the fabric that comes with this is pure raw silk, and this raw silk I want to make the trouser out of. So I've already cut the trouser, I've already cut the dress. The only thing that I've got to do is to cut the top portion of the trouser area, and I'm just going to explain that. So these pieces, that's for the two legs, and then that's for going on top of. There's two pieces like this, and there's two pieces like this, and they're going to go on the side over here just to give a little bit added thingy, and then these go on top over here. So far what we have is the bottom portion of the lega, all of the grana, all completed. Now the plain fabric with this, right, this is the plain fabric, and I'm just going to show you how I'm going to cut the top portion so that it's double folded. What I've done is just double folded this, and I'm going to cut it. You can cut it in two ways. You could either cut it so that it's but I'm going to cut it like this. I'll lay it like this so you can. So double folded, laid out like this. And what I'm going to do is, first of all, let's just straighten it out. So this is going to be like a, you know, one of them trouser type cuts where the front crutch is smaller than the back. That's exactly how I'm going to cut this. So I'm going to keep this slightly angled like this. And I'm going to cut away this bit. and then I'm going to cut this, and this portion is going to be the front of the trouser. So trim away the bottom of this, then just take the top two pieces and trim away for the front crutch. Now we're not going to create a joint in this, so that's why I'm saying just pick up the two pieces. Do you know how you have a problem with the crotch area and the trouser has this nasty pull? Well, that's what we want to avoid. Now the back, we're going to make this quite a bit wider. Now before you start complaining that I'm not showing this properly, I'll explain again, but really the truth of the pudding is in the eating. And what you will notice is when I actually come to try this on, you will be able to see that's the open version, okay, and this is the back crutch. Now we're on a grid table and I'm just going to give you a few hinters onto how this is. It's very difficult. What you've got to remember is that sewing is obviously a long time experience. You know, you don't become a tailor overnight, let me assure you. I have been sewing from the age of 16. Okay, so this is the width of the widest point of the thigh area, and this is about 32 inches. Okay, the back crutch goes to the length of approximately 15 and a half inches, and the gear of that back crutch is approximately 3.5 to 4 inches. Now in comparison to that, the front crutch is only about an inch, that's width, and the length of this is only about 10 and a half 11 inches. So it's less angled out, the back is more angled out, it's slightly at a slant. At the front you've got it slightly less, and at the back you've got it slightly more. And then also round here you would have this. The gear of the width of the knee area is about 25 inches, which I'm going to narrow down even slightly more because I will need, I won't need it as wide. Now, I've got to measure the length of this now and to make sure that is the right length, because there might be adjustments that I need to do to this. Now, as I explained earlier, this is where this bit is going to get attached to. Okay, so we've got to bear in mind that we've got to incorporate that also. And then underneath that, we've got, just pull this up so we can get more of the leg area. That will get attached to that, and then to this we will have this, and obviously this will all be lined as well. Then we've got this going along on this, and then I've got to bear in mind the length, the overall length that I require. Okay, now you don't want to make it overly lengthy. I want this falling about ready at 39 inches. So what we've got is, because we can narrow this down and make it less, what you want to do is measure from the, with your shoes on, measure from the floor length where you want the drop to, up to your knee length. And then this comes on, this motif comes on the, just above the knee onto the thigh. And then from the fall of the chemise, the fall of the chemise should fall just so that part of this flower shows. And then on top of from there, where you point that out to, what I would suggest is to join this, hold it on yourself and see that, let me just show you. Okay. What you want to be doing is, my floor is absolutely a mess. Okay, you want to be measuring from the floor up to where you want that to fall. And that should fall around about that area. So if that falls there, then measure from there up to your waist length. And that's the portion where you want to keep the top. So basically, my chemise is going to fall around about there. And my grara should start from about 3 inches, 2.5 inches above my knee. The portion where the embroidery part is. Now the embroidery part will fall just there, and otherwise it'll be just like a plain fall. And then the chemise, and obviously I'm going to explain the rest as we go along to stitching this. Now the only thing we've got to do is cut. I'm going to join these pieces up before I go ahead and cut the lining, and I will explain as we go along. Okay, so just a little bit of advice here. When you're working with delicate fabrics like chiffons, you've got to make sure that you treat these as the delicate thing that they are. This is pure georgette, which is slightly more difficult to handle than perhaps cottons and so on. So you might have slight bit of unevenness. What you have to do is sew this delicately and then press this. Make sure take full advantage of the iron and press it. Lay out flat on the table. You will have, make sure to cut slight bit extra and then trim it to size. So we're gonna trim these to size. I've laid these out. This is the additional piece that I added, and also that's the joints. And then I've made sure I've laid it out so that it comes on the center back. So what I'm going to do is I'm just trying to show you a close-up of basically what is going to come out like. These are two pieces. This is for the bottom leg. This is for the top of the thigh area. And before we marry these two off, combine them together, we're going to trim these to the actual size that we want. I don't know if they recorded or not. Well, basically what I've done is I've made sure that that's even. I've made sure that's even. I've made sure it's all trimmed to a side. I was taking a recording of this. Here I want it, the back, I want it longer than the front. So we've done a single leg, and I'm going to make sure that the size is right before I go on to placing this on the actual piece. And now this is going to be ready about 20 inches, 19.5, 20 inches. So I want to make sure that where I'm going to wear this is going to be right. 20 inches. It's just falling a little bit lower than what I want it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trim this down just a little bit so that it's not too long. So first of all, I'm going to take the crutch length here lower, and then the back of the crutch lower as well. And then I'm going to take, lay this open, and I'm going to take an inch or so away from the top in a straight line. This is to lower the length because I don't want it too long, because otherwise you're sort of like pulling it apart. Now this is perfectly trimmed off. What I'm going to do is get my other piece and lay this down. This is not being trimmed at all, so this is the initial cutting, and we're going to perfect according to the one that we just cut. dots laid out. Now what we've got to do is make sure that the embroidery goes in line with the embroidery. So make sure that the fabrics are facing each other. Fabrics are facing each other and embroidery to embroidery, and then laid out, all straightened out, and we're going to trim this to exactly the same size as this the cutout piece. So that's the back crutch, the front crutch. This is just going to get all trimmed out so that they're exactly two identical pieces. Don't try cutting them together, because this is, like I said, this is a very delicate material. You need to treat it very delicately as well. Otherwise, you're going to end up, the last thing you want is making a mistake on something like this and then try and fix it, because you will just ruin the garment. There we are, that's all perfectly laid out. Now we're going to trim away. Even if you have to trim a slight bit off the original, that's fine, because that's going to give you a perfect two pieces. Take full advantage of the iron, take full advantage of a cutting area that helps you with a perfect layout. And this is called perfection. This is how you perfect things. Okay, so now we've got the whole leg done. What we're going to do is just do that seam, put the two together on the crutch, and then the upper portion of the leg area is done. Okay, and I'll just place that over here and show you what we're going to do with our bottom portion. First of all, this needs trimming and cutting. So we need to make sure that the length of this is right, and placing these on top of each other symmetric so that both of them are trim away the excess, any hanging, overhanging threads and so on, and neaten it off. And then we're going to measure from where we want the fall of the, so from the ankle to the knee, I want it about 20 inches long. So I'm going to trim this bit away. This is already closed off, and I'm going to pleat this and place that on top, just do the bottom turning, and that should complete the outer leg. Now the inner, the lining, I'm going to cut like a just like a loose churidar type of a trouser, and place that on the inside, just attach it at the belt and let these both fall on their own falling. So you can already see the shape of this. Now the difference to the picture and ours is we're going to have this as a centerpiece on the knee area, there, and then we will also have a centerpiece going up from the back, well actually not in the area, sort of like a side view area. And we're also going to have a back panel which is going to go up and which is sort of like going to look floral. So a slight bit of a change to the original design, but I'm sure you'll agree that it's going to come out an absolutely exceptional piece of work. So this is the embroidered patch that came with the suit. It's hand-done work with lots of detailing, and what we've done is just ironed on little bits of a wonder web. I'm going to peel away the backing off this, and some of this wonder web has glued onto this. I just want it enough so that it can these. It's actually stuck onto the glue, has not come off fully. And what we're going to do is get the gummies portion. And place this in the right spot where we want to iron this onto. Once in the right place, place something on top of it, like a scarf or something, because you don't want the beads rolling, and then just press that into place, and that should, the glue should just melt and stick to the this to the sewing machine and trim around all of the embroidery around this, and also the neckline is sort of going towards one side. It's more of a, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a little bit of detailing to the one side just to bring that in, because it's not just not going to look right the way it is. But I'm going to add something like this kind of beading going across, but that's something that I will do later on. Actually no, I will do it now. I will do it now and then that way. So let's have a look what pieces we've got left over. Okay, we've got something like this. I might just add, I've got that, or I've got this. I'm not quite keen on the actual neck thing. Oh yeah, I'm gonna add this along here just to bring the neckline sort of more in line with that side. It is a slightly higher neckline. A lot of the necklines that are coming at the moment, they are quite close to the neck, which not everybody is keen on. See, the other alternative we have is to add something like this. Do add something like that. Do you know what? I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm not going to add to that. I'm going to add something like this to make the neckline. Just to give it a little bit more detailing. Right, that's what we're going to do. Just half of the neckline. That's a job for later on. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just trim around here. I've not cut into it because it's a one-sided neck. I want the neck to be, yeah, and then on the back of the neckline, I think I'm going to have to zip it because, or put a tie at the back. Okay, we also need to trim away this. Was a video recording and the recorder went off. Okay, so I'm going to give you a little bit of a brief description of a sleeve and an armhole, the sleeve cap and how it fits in on the dress. So here what I've done is I've just trimmed it all off and I've finished it off. This is lying on a grid table and I'm just going to give you a little bit of a description of what this sleeve is like. So the length of the sleeve, and then if you look over here, that is like the cap, that is the cutting of the armhole, where it's going to fit into the armhole, sorry, and that's the sleeve cutting. Now here I want it quite fitted sleeve. It's about 4 inches, 4.5 inches in length where it starts off from, and it's curved off, and then the cap of this is about 2.5 inches and sort of curled around, and then here it's got the point of the top of the arm, the top of the armhole is top of the circumference of the arm is round here. I've measured this and I've just left it just enough for seaming, and then narrowed it off to the point of the elbow and then widened it off as we go along. So that is, that sort of is how your sleeve should look like. Okay, and if you do a sleeve like this, it will look perfect and it will fit perfect. Okay, so we're gonna close this sleeve off with a seam going all the way across and then press it and keep this to a side. That's the sleeve ready before we go on to fixing the, I'm not gonna line the sleeve, I'm just gonna leave it as it is. So before we fix it onto the dress, and we're just gonna get the dress part finished off. So I've prepared the back of the dress, I've attached the border and pressed it out, laid it out. I'm gonna get the perfect sort of like cut on this before I attach the two together, because I want this to be an absolutely perfect fit. So I'm going to measure around my bust area, and I am going to mark this out just exactly how many inches I want this, how many inches I want the front, and then how many inches I want at the back. So from 40 I'm going to minus the front portion, which is about 24, so we're left with 16, and half of 16 is, oh no, that can't be right, that can't be right. Okay, I'm gonna measure, that is right, 16 inches. So we only want this about that much, to be honest. Okay, I'm gonna go around up to there. I want the jaw falling around about here on the hip point, and then this portion I'm also, I have to cut wider at the back because the neckline on this dress is quite, tight at the front, so I'm gonna have to cut a deeper neckline at the back. I don't normally like my necklines deep at the back, but with this particular one we're going to have a deeper neckline, and I'm also going to trim this off. But before I trim any of this off, I'm going to measure, just quickly going to press the front of this in half as well. I'm going to press it in half so that we know exactly where we stand, because we're limited on the fabric for the daman because it has embroidery, and the embroidery is already done to a particular size. Now, you know, yesterday somebody made a comment on the video that I did yesterday that have I lost weight, and what was the secret of losing the weight? Let me assure you that I have not lost weight. I am still as fat as ever, at least that's what I feel. Now from the daman, I'm going to make the back of this dress a little bit wider, and as you can see, just by guessing, my guess is generally very accurate. Okay, so my guess is generally very accurate. I need to trim this down. I need to trim this down from the shoulders. So we are going to take away this excess on the shoulder area. We're also going to lengthen the armhole and then narrow this down at the back. Then as we go towards the hip area and the jaw, I'm going to leave the back daman a little bit longer, wider, because the overall width of the gear of this is actually quite less. So I'm going to make the back just a little bit wider than the front. I'll just give you a preview of what that looks like. So as you can see, that little bit excess there is the gamiz just coming out just slightly wider. What I'll do now is I will finish off. I will go and do the patchwork around here, attach this on, and then finish the neckline off. I'm just going to do like a rough thingy, like a fabric underneath it, and then here I'm gonna do is attach this just together, try it out, make sure that the fitting is right. If the fitting is right, then I'm going to attach the lining. I'm going to coat that separate. Well, actually, I'll do that right now. Now, the fabric that I was going to use for that is this Lycra fabric. A bit of an unusual fabric to use. But you know what? That is going to give me a very, very good fit. It's all about, this is Lycra fabric, and it's like a Lycra jersey. So I'm going to line it in this jersey. And this is going to be a, like a nice fitting top. In jersey. Crazy. You're probably thinking, crazy woman. What is she doing? I like being adventurous. It's my, what you call it? I used to have this seamstress who used to work for me, and she used to constantly say to me, you know, you have this, it's called Janoon. It's like a mad frenzy type of a passion when it comes to, I go a bit crazy. Okay, so what I'm going to do is sometimes, you know, I go through these phases. I'll go through a phase when I've gone completely off sewing. And then I'll come back to it, and I'll come back to it with a vengeance, like where I'd go completely mad, and I'd forget about anything and everything around me. And that's a very difficult time for my family, because I forget that they exist. Maybe the sewing machinists, sewing enthusiasts out there who would share my passion in that, when I turn around and say that. We want the length of this to be sort of like almost the length of the camise. We also want some parts of this same as the camise. Although this is going to be stretchy, and it's going to stretch and okay, I'm going to just cut this neckline too. That I marked out and I never cut out. This is the back of the neckline. I'm going to trim this again because I'm not going to make this like this wide, especially on the armholes and stuff. This is just a general cutting of this lining. My machine manages to stitch this, because sometimes the machines don't always stitch this fabric. We shall wait and see. Okay, we're going to come back to the armhole and the neck. I want that neck to be nice and wide. Don't want it visibly showing through the thingy of the dress. And I also want the armhole to be nice and wide. So this is just like a okay. That's going to be the chemise. And whilst we're at it, we're going to cut we're going to cut the lining for the trouser part as well. For the grana as well, we're going to cut the lining. lot of the time, what you can do is sometimes you have fabrics like this lying around at home, especially in blacks and whites and stuff, and you can just easily use these to make the. And I'll tell you something that you can use for the top portion of the cutting. You can use this as your template. Do you remember the one that I showed you how to lay it out and how to cut it? Well, you can use that for the pajama like cutting, because this is kind of like a similar cut that we want. For, you know, the top of this is going to be sort of like almost the same. The crotch, the leg. There you are. There's always benefits in. Very important, valuable tip there for you. Where I'm just using, I'm just going to leave this slightly, very, very slightly excess of the bottom one. There we are, that's just all the excess away. Length of the trouser. The back crutch, now, I'm sorry to be a bit of a nuisance and trying to get my arm across, but it's quite difficult to. Right, I'm going to move this away, pull these two together, lay them out and measure the leg length. Now this is, again, like I mentioned, this is stretchy material. What you want to do is measure the inside leg, which is there, and you want to measure this about 28 inches. Lego ground going on top of this. Just make it, it's always easier to amend it, so make it just a little bit longer. Don't end up running short. And that's the lining for the portion of the grana. Yeah, I know it looks a bit wonky. Just straighten this out. See, I have a habit of impulsive cutting, so I don't normally measure and I don't normally do any of that. I just go for it. There we are. That's the inner lining of the grana, and I can actually go on to finishing the grana now. I've just got to make sure that matches and just drop it inside the outer piece. Okay, this is one of my boxes of goodies that I bought a while ago from the Wish app. This has got all the essential pieces for working with embroidery and so on, and beads and so on. So what I need from here is a piece which is going to go, I've got to go around the outer of this. Even though I've left a slight bit on an excess, I need to go as close as possible. So in here, what I want to look for is a tool, a piece which is going to be like one-sided. That's going to take me closer to, and I can't really seem to see any. seem to see anyone side foot. They've given so many pieces and they've not given the one piece that I really need, and that's like a zip foot. Okay, so I'm gonna share with you a few tips before we finish off this Maryams design number 18. It's from a Maryams luxury embroidered collection, Maryams gold collection. So far I have done, I'm going to share with you what I have done with this suit and then sort of guide you on what we're doing next. So I've stitched the gamis, I've stitched this sort of like separately. I haven't put no lining or anything with it because I am going to attach the lining. As you can see, the suit looks absolutely stunning. Now we had a slight bit of a problem with using this motif. I couldn't use the machine to do this with, so I tacked it down with the wonder web, and what I'm going to do is just go around the edges by hand because it's not something that the machine will stitch close to. Now apart from that, everything else I've lined the neckline and stuff and I've finished it off. I'm going to turn this inside out and I'm going to show you how I'm going to go about putting the lining on this. So the dress, I'm just going to lay it out like this. The lining, I have stitched this. So this is like a lycra material, not lycra, it's jersey material. And the way I'm going to use this is right sides facing up. I'm going to just lay it like this. Okay, and I'm going to just attach this up to the jacks and also attach this on the other side up to the jacks. Now I think it looks just a little bit wide because I want this really nicely fitted because it stretches, and I want this like a figure hugging. So it looks like it's a little bit wider than, no, perhaps not. There's a little bit of a give in the gummies. So this, and then the same on the other side. I'm going to lay it down, and this has all been finished off. I've hemmed the edges of the sleeves, I've hemmed the neckline, I've done the jacks, I've done the bottom tarpai. So basically the lining is going to be attached on the shoulders there and attached on the sides. It's going to be free on the sleeves, it's going to be free around the neckline, free on the sleeve there, and free flowing from the bottom down. Once I've done that, I will try it on to make sure that the fitting is right. That's the sleeve. I've finished that off to exactly the shape of how I wanted it. And that's both of the sleeves, and I'm going to fit those onto the dress. So that really, and then finish off the gamis. I'm going to use this rosy pink silk to trim off the sides of this. And then the final finishing, I'm going to attach the beads, and that will be the gamis done. Okay, that's the gamis. Now with the salwar, again, what we've done is we've stitched. This is the top portion of the grara. I've not lined it or anything, and it's like a shorts. Okay, this is all finished off. And what I'm gonna do is get the portion for the bottom. I'll finish this off as well, and then I'm going to gather this and fit that into there, and that will form the grara, both the legs. And what we're going to have is the back of the leg. I mean, I've tried to widen this up a little bit. I'm going to just gather this on that side, the other piece onto the other side, and then this is all being finished off and pressed, by the way. So again, that's for the other leg. I'm just going to put some gathers in there and just place it in there and stitch it around. Do the end turnings. And the other thing that I want to share with you is the, take that away for a minute, this is the jersey lining trouser. Once I've finished that off, I'm going to just attach this on the waist area and then just elasticate the whole thing, and that shall be it. There we are. This is going to give me a wonderfully comfortable fit, both in the chemise and in this. It'll also be like quite figure hugging and warm at the same time. So even though it's winter, I can still get away with the suit as a wintry suit. It's quite thin material. And now that's for the trouser bottom. That's all I've got left, two pieces like this. This one I'm going to put a little bit of a seam in there, just seam that together. Actually, seam that together like that. And then what I'm going to do is just add a small amount of pieces on both the sides just to lengthen it up. Plus, I don't want this to catch on the, you know, these edges. I don't want them catching on the seam because it can irritate you on the legs. And then once this is done, I'm going to attach this to the trouser bottoms so the trouser will match the, you know, if I want to wear it as a trouser suit or if I want to wear it with the legger.